I'll be showing you how to make a sweater boot using old sneakers and a pair of sweater. This is the design of the shoe that I will be doing. It's inspired by the Lucky brand, or the Uggs, in which you can get them for starting at $70 or even up to $150 for these type of boots. Celebrities also use them as well, as you can see here. They like to rock out these sweater boots. Here are the items that you will need: an old sweater, old sneaker, shoe glue, rubber orthotics, 2 inches width, 2 yards long cotton fabric, shoelace, latex glove, needle and thread, blanket, and other items that you may need or will speak of later. After you cut the pieces out, you're going to sew the inner fabric together, the blanket, and you're going to sew them using the zigzag stitch. You're going to repeat the process with the old sweater using the right size facings together, as well as using the zigzag stitch. After sewing the two pieces together from the inner fabric and the outer fabric, you're going to attach them together by aligning the two seams together, right size facing together. And you're going to attach them by using the straight stitch all around the corners. After you sewn around the edges of the two pieces, you're going to leave a little space out so that you can be able to flip it. She is love, and she is all I need. 'Cause when that world slows down. After sewing them using the straight stitch, you're going to cut the extra fabric that you have left around the edges, and particularly cut the corner of the fabric at a triangle, so that when you flip it inside out, it'll be able to be flat. After you flip it inside out, you're going to close the closure using a straight stitch. Take your rubber orthotics and cut them to the length of the sneaker that you have gotten. Make sure that the actual sneaker is a little bit bigger than your actual shoe size, so that your feet will be able to fit after you cut it out. Cut the shoe where the sole, the rubber sole, is still intact, and keep the leather part still attached. Then place the rubber orthotics and make sure that they will both fit. Using the cotton trim, you're going to attach that to the fabric for the outer shoe, and the tongue of the shoe, you're going to attach it along the edges, making the right size of the fabric facing up so that you are able to flip it. Also, make sure that once you attach the leather back of the shoe with the fabric, you can attach it using upholstery needle and upholstery thread so that you can tightly fasten it. Make sure that the circumference, the length of the cotton, is the circumference of the entire sneaker. After you have sewn the trim onto the fabric, you're going to attach the fabric to the orthotics that the inner sole. After you have glued them together, you're going to wait for it to dry and attach the inner rubber sole to the outer sole quickly using the shoe glue and hot glue gun. Finally, with wearing rubber gloves, you're going to use the shoe glue and glue along the edge of the sole and spread them using your finger a smooth surface so that when it dries, it won't be clumpy. After you have after the shoe has dried, you need to punch in the eyelets that you can refer to this tutorial here on the link below. And then voila! You have your own shoe sweater boot using old sneakers and an old sweater. Find out a rockin' shoelace and attach it and you'll be set to go. If you want to learn more traditional ways of making shoe, there is a great website called handmadeshoes.wordpress.com. It shows you step-by-step photos of how the shoe is made and how the sole is attached to it in a traditional Norwegian sewing technique. It's a great way to check it out. So, I hope you enjoy. Thank you for watching.